previous class we discussed classification of ligands. Okay, that classification is based on the charge present on the ligand and based on the density of the ligands, right? Now in this class we are going to discuss classification of ligands based on the nature of their bonding. Okay, classification of ligands based on the nature of their bonding, that is the third and final classification. Already we discussed two classifications combined together. Now we are going to discuss the final classification, that is based on the nature of ligand. Okay, so first one is ambidentate ligands. Okay, ambidentate ligands. So let us see what is an ambidentate ligand. A ligand that may have more than one type of donor sites, but at a time only one kind of donor site is utilized for donation, is called as ambidentate ligand. Means a ligand have more than one type of donor site. Donor site means donor atom. Okay, but at a time while it is participating in bonding with the central metal atom, it may utilize only one kind of donor atom, only one kind, one type, not one. Okay, so because one is different and one kind is different, that we discuss. Okay, so one kind of donor atom at a time is utilized, that is called as ambidentate ligand. Okay, the ligand which have more than one type of donor atoms, but at a time, that is using only one type of donor atom. Okay, that is called as ambidentate ligand. And this ambidentate ligands is generally two types. One is ambidentate and monodentate. Ambidentate and monodentate. And another one is ambidentate and bidentate. Ambidentate and bidentate. Ambidentate and monodentate means the donors. Okay, the donor atoms is only one in a ligand. Okay, only one donor atom in a ligand, that is monodentate, right? And if that act as an ambidentate ligand, that is called ambidentate monodentate ligand. And there are some other ligands which have two donor atoms, okay, which have two donor atoms, that is bidentate ligands, which can act as ambidentate ligand, bidentate and ambidentate. Okay, let us first start ambidentate and monodentate. Okay, ambidentate and monodentate. Monodentate means only one donor atom, right? One donor atom. See, if we take cyanide ion, okay, the formula is Cn minus. So this negative charge is present on this ion is delocalized negative charge. Okay, delocalized negative charge. Now, here, carbon may bond to the central metal atom or nitrogen may bond to the central metal atom, depending upon the nature of the complex or nature of the bonding. See here, suppose if carbon is bonding with the central metal atom, that is called as cyanido. Cyanido, or in the old system, cyano. Okay, cyanido. See here, carbon is bonded to the metal atom. If the cyanide ion or ligand is bonded through nitrogen atom to the central metal atom, then that is called isocyanido or isocyano in the old system. Isocyanido. See here, same ion only, Cn minus only. Cyanido means carbon is bonding to the central metal atom. Isocyanido means nitrogen is bonding to the central metal atom. Okay, depending upon the donor atom. See here, in this one, if carbon is donating electron pair to the metal or carbon is forming coordinate bond with the metal, then nitrogen cannot participate in the bonding with the metal atom. Okay. Or if nitrogen is bonded to the metal atom, here carbon cannot donate lone pair or it cannot form bond with the metal atom. Clear? Okay. Ambidentate ligand means the ligand which has more than one type of donor atom, but at a time it can donate only one donor, one pair through single atom. Okay. So that is ambidentate ligand. Okay. Clear? See here, carbon is forming bond with the central metal atom. Here nitrogen is forming bond with the central metal atom. When carbon is involved in bonding, nitrogen does not form any bond. Or when nitrogen is forming bond with the central metal atom, carbon does not form any bond. Okay, clear? So this is about cyanide. Next, cyanate ion, OCN minus. OCN minus, cyanate. See here also. Now, if this ligand is formed bond through oxygen atom. Okay, formed bond with the central metal atom through oxygen atom, then that is called cyanato. Cyanato. Okay, or if the ligand forms bond through nitrogen atom with the central metal atom, that is called as isocyanato. Isocyanato, clear? Cyanato ligand is forming bond through oxygen atom. Isocyanato ligand is forming bond through nitrogen atom. Clear? Next, thiocyanate ion. Thiocyanate ion, SCN minus. See here. If sulfur is forming bond with the central metal atom, that is thiocyanato, or if the ligand is forming bond through nitrogen atom with the central metal atom, then that is isothiocyanato. Okay. If the bond donor atom is sulfur, thiocyanato. If the donor atom is isothionitrogen, then that is isothiocyanato. Okay, clear? This is about thiocyanate ion. Next one is nitrite ion. Nitrite ion. See here, in this nitrite ion, if nitrogen is the donor atom, then that is nitro. Okay, nitro. Or if oxygen is the donor atom, then that is nitrito. Nitro, nitrito. Okay, nitro. Nitrogen is forming bond with the central metal atom or ion, nitro. If oxygen is forming with the forming bond with the central metal atom, that is nitrito. Okay, nitro, nitrito. Clear? So this is about ambidentity ligand. These are the major examples. We discuss one more example and another type, that is ambidentate and bidentate. Clear? This one, ambidentate and monodentate ligand. Okay, so what is ambidentate? A ligand which have more than one type of donor atom, right? More than one type of donor atom. But at a time, if it is forming bond by utilizing single donor atom, that is called as ambidentate ligand. Okay, here using carbon, here using nitrogen. It has two types of donor atoms. In some complexes, it will use carbon as donor atom. In some other complexes, it will use nitrogen as donor atom. Okay. Next example is thiosulfato ion. Thiosulfato ion, H2O3 2-. Okay, see here, this is the structure of thiosulfate ion. If so, oxygen is participating in the bonding, or oxygen is the donor atom, then that is thiosulfato O. Okay, so this ligand is bonded to the central metal atom or ion through oxygen atom, then that is thiosulfato O. Okay, next, if the ligand is bonded to the central metal atom or ion through the sulfur atom, then that is thiosulfato S. Okay, if the ligand is bonded to the central metal atom or ion through oxygen atom, thiosulfato O. If the ligand is bonded to the central metal atom through the sulfur atom, thiosulfato S. Okay, thiosulfato O, thiosulfato S. This is about ambidentate and monodentate ligands, very very important examples. Next type is ambidentate and bidentate ligand. Ambidentate and bidentate ligand. H2C2O2 2-, dithiooxalate ion. Oxalate is C2O4 2-, right? If in the place of two oxygens we have two sulfurs, that is dithiooxalate ion. Okay, here, see, it is the structure. Now, in this ligand, if oxygen atoms has negative charge and they act as donor atoms, okay, they act as donor atoms, and two oxygens are bonded to the metal atom from the same ligand, mean that is a bidentate ligand, right? Already we discussed. If a single ligand has two donor atoms, that is a bidentate ligand. Now here, this is a bidentate ligand and bonded through same type. See here, both are same. Oxygen ligand is bonded to the metal atom, right? Next here, so that's why it is dithiooxalate O. Dithiooxalate O. Next, here if the same ligand is H2C2O2 2-, or if sulfur atoms has a negative charge, then they are bonded to the central metal atom, then that is called as dithiooxalate S. Okay, see here, in this ligand, either two oxygen atoms may have negative charge,
Okay, or either two sulfur atoms may have negative charge. Okay, clear? Okay, so here it is diethioxalate O, diethioxalate S. Ambidentate. Because in this one, it is bonding to the central metal atom or ion through oxygen atoms. One type. Okay, that may be one atom or two atoms. One type. Oxygen atoms. Okay, two oxygen atoms are bonding to the metal atom. So that's why it is ambidentate and bidentate ligand. Here, sulfur, same type. Sulfur is bonded to the central metal atom. Two sulfurs are bonding from the single ligand. So that's why it is bidentate, ambidentate. Okay, so this is about ambidentate ligands. Okay, in the next class we discuss flexidentate ligands.